What kind of beast is this shock operational tactical unmanned aerial vehicle? The realities of modern warfare are such that a variety of technical innovations are increasingly used to achieve their goals. Recently, unmanned aerial vehicles, or UAVs, have begun to gain momentum, which are capable of performing both reconnaissance missions and delivering missile strikes against ground targets. And this is not surprising, because this modern aviation technology solves many military tasks, whilst not endangering the lives of pilots. The Turkish Bayraktar TB2 UAVs, which have passed field tests and have proven themselves in military conflicts in Libya, Syria and Nagorno-Karabakh, are especially popular at the moment. The Turkish company Baykar Makina began developing unmanned aerial vehicles in 2000. Paradoxically, until this manufacturer since 1984 was engaged exclusively in the production of automotive equipment and components. But in 2000, he changed the profile of his employment and achieved solid results in the aircraft industry. So, in 2004, Baykar Makina conducted the first flight tests of autonomous aircraft, and in 2005, presented the first Turkish Bayraktar mini drones. However, the Turkish designers did not stop there, and already in 2014, the first flight tests passed the Bayraktar TB2 UAV, which entered service with the Turkish Army and aroused particular interest among Qatar, Azerbaijan, and Ukraine. Bayraktar TB2 is a strike tactical unmanned aerial vehicle, or UAV, being developed in Turkey, able to accelerate to 200 kilometers per hour and climb to a height of more than 8 kilometers. Bayraktar drops aerial bombs and guided anti-tank missiles. In this case, the drone can be in flight for a day. The drone got its name in honor of the founder of the Baykar company, which manufactures reconnaissance and strike drones, Özdemir Bayraktar. Translated from Turkish, the name can be translated as banner. Length 6.5 meters. Load capacity 55 kilograms. Maximum takeoff weight 650 kilograms. Wingspan 12 meters. Maximum speed 222 kilometers per hour. Cruising speed 130 kilometers per hour. Range depends on the version. The first version is 150 kilometers. The updated version is 300 kilometers. Autonomy 24 hours. Ceiling 8,200 meters. Where are the Bayraktars used? Bayraktar TB2 reconnaissance and strike drones can destroy everything. For example, various Grad or Buk anti-aircraft missile systems, also tanks, and entire columns of equipment. Even with the older version having a range of 150 kilometers, you can keep a constant watch in the air and move quickly to launch a missile when a target is detected. One Bayraktar can carry two UMTAS guided anti-tank missiles, laser-guided and launch range from 0.5 to 8 kilometers, or four Roketsan MAMC, Bozok and Roketsan MAML high-precision gliding corrective bombs, capable of hitting a movable and immovable target at a distance up to 8 kilometers. It is thanks to their characteristics that these drones pose an extreme danger to the enemy army. Bayraktars are fast, light, agile, deadly, and easy to control. It is difficult for the invaders to neutralize these reconnaissance and strike drones because they are almost impossible to detect. The Bayraktar TB2 UAV gained particular popularity during the military conflict between Armenia and Azerbaijan in Nagorno-Karabakh. These unmanned aerial vehicles were actively used by the Azerbaijani army, performing both reconnaissance functions and inflicting pinpoint strikes on enemy equipment and manpower. Ultimately, as you know, Azerbaijan managed to take control of these territories. Also, Bayraktar TB2 UAVs were actively used by the Turkish side in the Syrian conflict. It is worth recalling the military operation Spring Shield in Idlib, as a result of which 8 units of the Russian self-propelled air defense missile system Pantsir S-1 were destroyed by these drones. Control system. The ground crew of the Turkish strike drone consists of 3 people: a commander, a pilot, and a weapon operator. When performing a combat mission, they are located at the control station, which is transported in a van mounted on the chassis of a heavy truck. The equipment is supplied with an autonomous power source. One ground station can simultaneously control the flights of 3 drones. The set of equipment also includes installation for refueling UAV tanks, reserve fuel supply up to 800 liters, charger for onboard drone batteries, video archiving system designed for recording and subsequent storage of reports during flights, the software receiving the information from the UAV constantly determines its exact coordinates and calculates the most optimal routes for the drone during the mission. If you enjoyed our video, please subscribe to our channel, and we'll look forward to seeing you in the next.